From ABC7, this is News at 6.
It's gross, it smells, and it's your big story tonight at 6. Red tide is rearing its ugly head yet again. We saw this right after Hurricane Ian. We saw it years ago after Hurricane Irma, and it is back right now. Thank you so much for joining us on your ABC7 News at 6. I'm Jeff Harris.
And I'm Megan Miller. Like you said, we have seen these toxic algae blooms looming around our coast, and now dead fish are popping up in Charlotte County. ABC7's Samantha Serban is on Englewood Beach tonight. She's getting us more on why it was even worse over the weekend.
If I didn't want to be here, they shouldn't be here either.
It's the idea of saving others a trip that started Tim Chula's daily red tide reports.
Pretty bad out here.
Every day, he posts a video sharing what the conditions are like here at Englewood Beach. He's known as the beach guy, renting out chairs and umbrellas for more than a decade. Today, those are sparse on the sand as a red tide trickles in.
Yesterday was very bad. You couldn't even stay out here for 5 minutes.
Today isn't so intense, the tide causing minor irritation and sending some fish here up on shore, but I'm told this is nothing compared to Saturday.
And then the fish and everything was so bad, and everybody was coughing and sneezing. The tickle in the throat, it's called a red tide tickle.
Chula says he set up shop today, hoping to make a buck or two, but quickly sent his staff home.
So this is our busiest time of the year, and this is when we kind of plan on making all our money for the whole year during season, and when we have a bout that happens like this, it really makes it tough.
All he can do now is wait and hope for a change in the winds.
A westerly wind brings the toxins from the Gulf that have been stirred up and brings it on shore. The east wind blows it away and takes it out to sea. So we pray for east winds.
Reporting today in Englewood Beach, Samantha Serban, ABC7.
Let's get you.